Kosovo, they asked me, because a foreigner has another value for them, to launch a project, to manage a project. And I am vice president of the International Yehudi-Menuhin Foundation, as you know, which is responsible for the network. I start with the beginning. It was in 1992 when I visited Yehudi-Menuhin. I mean, I must translate. Sorry.
Yes.
Yeah. This day, it was the 31st of August in 1992, when I met Yehudi-Menuhin. He had a wonderful chalet, holiday house in the Swiss mountains in Gstaad, where is also the Yehudi-Menuhin Festival. Yeah, very famous Yehudi-Menuhin Festival.
El Yehudi era ciudadano suizo, nacido en Estados Unidos, no británico,
yeah,
y europeo por decisión
propia. Yeah, and then in this meeting we discussed the point that the values of the arts are not enough respected in the society.
Yeah.
And we wanted to change this fundamentally. So, and 2 weeks later he called me, listen, Werner, I have an appointment with Federico Mayor, who was at that time the Director General of the UNESCO. And naturally, I went to Paris with him, and we had a wonderful meeting with Federico Mayor.
Que es miembro de nuestro patronato.
Yeah. And he said, yeah, your ideas are wonderful, but you must have a project, otherwise you will not succeed. And then in 1993 we invited experts from different countries, I think from 10 countries, pedagogues, teachers, and musicians, to a 3 days conference, also to Gstaad, where the festival is. And
es un festival, el Alpen Festival, que organizaba Yehudi, un festival de música que era en verano, a final de agosto.
Yeah, maybe you don't know it, but it's very famous, internationally famous. And in this 3 days, we created the guidelines of Muse, which is, as you know, 2 hours per week in the school. Our professional artists are present in these 2 hours in the school, in the classroom. The teacher has to be active, participating, and so on. You know all these guidelines. And this is, since then, established and was always the same. Yeah, and then we didn't know if it really works. So in 2 classes of a primary school in the city of Bern, we tested Muse. And in the springtime in 1994, we had a second preparation conference where the big number of the participants of the first conference came once more to Bern, and we visited the school. Yes, at that time I was 20 years director of the Bern Conservatory, so I had all the connections. And the teachers and the artists were, without any exception, had the idea, for them it is absolutely fantastic, the results. Children have changed their mind, they were much more tolerant, and all these effects, what we only theoretically thought, were realized, and it was the first classes, the beginners, And these two teachers said, never we would start a new class in the school without music practice. Yeah, and from this moment on, it distributed in 6 countries. That was Hungary, Estonia, Switzerland, France, and Netherlands, I think. No, Belgium. And unfortunately, Estonia didn't have the money later on, and in France we had special problems. Now we have again in France Muse, but it's now 4 times it crashed totally. The centralized education system in France seems to be very unfriendly for projects like Muse. Yeah, and Yehudi Menuhin, he had friends with kings and presidents of different nations, and he was in favor of this project. But it seems for me, as a person living not in France, that this education administration is so strong that even a president cannot change anything. There are so many social problems that Muse could give support to these problems. So I think you in Spain can be very proud that you have such a successful Muse organization in your country. And every time when I came here, and not the first time, to meet artists and teachers, I am always really satisfied about this atmosphere, about your will to change something and to support it. It's great. Thank you very much. And today we are in 13 countries present. And I hope that Spain is a good example for other countries as well. I will go in March to Bulgaria. The ambassador, the Bulgarian ambassador there, has invited me to Sofia, and the idea is to start there also music. Yeah, and now I am here, or we are here, together with Linda, to speak about our experience in Germany. And this is a special story. In 1996, Yehudi wanted, together with the television of Cologne, to launch in Germany, in the part of Cologne, Düsseldorf, Muse. And so I tried to make contact with the ministry, and we found a school that was in 1996. And then it became very large in Muse in Germany. 1999, unfortunately, Yehudi Menuhin died, and before he died, he founded the German Yehudi Menuhin Foundation. And on the base of this foundation, there were at the end 700 classes in Germany. And the manager of Muse Germany, Winfried Klei, were very close together with you, Annabelle. And unfortunately, in 2011, the government of the Bundesland Nordrhein-Westfalen, you know that is a region in Germany, the administration discovered that for a huge project, the financing didn't allow a part of what we had as expenses. For instance, it was a a project combined with the European Union, and then they create these functioners, the responsible found out that a part was not corresponding to the law of the European Union. So we started a new structure, an association MUSE Germany, with a seat in Frankfurt.
Entonces es ahí donde comenzamos una nueva organización con una nueva estructura con base en Frankfurt.
Yeah. And so at the time now we have around 20 classes running. But as I am living in Switzerland, it's for me very difficult to run a project in this country, Germany, which is very large. And now I am very glad that in my hometown, in the region south of Cologne, I don't know if you know where the river Rhine and Mosel is crossing, where I am born and educated, in this small city, we have now 4 MUSE classes, 4 of these 20 in total, and I have Linda here. She is one of the class teachers of these 4 classes. The headmaster of the school was also supposed to come, but 2 days ago he became so ill that it was impossible to travel. Yeah, and now this project is very new, and the teachers are not really experienced. I found artists, very good artists, at one of the visual art and one dancer, and the class of Linda, I can show you. We have also pictures here, but we have no projection. Doesn't matter. We can explain a little bit how we established this there. Yeah, and I would like to ask Linda how she feels now as a new MUSE teacher.
In general, I feel good. It's very a new and nice experience. For my whole life, I'm dancing, and so I've got a special connection to this in general too. But also, my colleagues are very proud to have this project in our school. We are a school with 265 pupils, and you know, in Germany, we have 16 different school systems. And in my area, Rheinland-Pfalz, and we have 13 classes at our school. And the system is that there are pupils who stay in school just until 12 or 1 o'clock. And the other ones, is optional in our area, stay until 4 o'clock. And so we have different systems in one school system, which is also system 1, as it's a little bit complicated. And my last class, which I had for 4 years, was also a class like now, where all the pupils stay until 4 o'clock with me. And so you have totally different opportunities to work with these children. It's like a special rhythm, because you can have mathematics also in the afternoon. I'm absolutely flexible, and I like that more than the additional system. Mm-hmm. And it's very good also for MUSE, because I'm more flexible. And for example, I've got MUSE in the afternoon, Monday afternoon, 2 hours, mm-hmm. The artist comes. Mm-hmm. Yes. And that's why also the parents are very thankful to have such a professional and a good working project, an international project in the school in my class. Because it's the system also that you should have projects in this class, which days until 4 o'clock. But also the other three colleagues are very happy with the project. They have it in the morning, 2 hours per week. Mm-hmm. And in this year we have two artists, one visual artist, professional painter, and the other one is the dancer. And after a while we changed it. Mm-hmm. So that I got the dancer and the other ones have the visual artist.
In normally it's 6 months the same artist in the classroom, and then it changes. And maybe I must say something general from when we made the concept of Muse, and I had very often a critic from my colleagues, you know, I am cellist and musician. Why not only music, also the possibility to be closer to different art forms, to learn a musical instrument or to learn to become a dancer. It's only a tool for the sensibilization of the children, the emotional and corporal sensibilization. And there, and from Muse, from this platform, children can discover their real preference of art. The corporal and emotional sensibilization.
Una sensibilidad corporal y emocional.
That you can see the children absolutely like it. And yeah. I think it's enjoying art without any pressure. Right? The normal lesson you have, okay, paint a picture and make that, and then the teacher get it and okay. It's not so hard in the first class, because in the first and second class we don't have any marks. Marks. Mm-hmm. But although they feel it, that we have this things in our mind, these points, and here it's absolutely free. And mm-hmm. every picture is something special, and the children feel it, and that you can see.
Mm-hmm. But the child has the possibility to discover through Muse the real preference for one art form. And then, if it works like it should, there can be led a child to the right formation later on, to music school or dancing school or whatever, and the talent can be discovered. Yeah, and this small city, Mayen, has 20,000 inhabitants, right? And people said, we don't have artists here in this region. But that it was not true. It was because there was no coordinator. I had to find people and artists. It was very easy for me, in my network, even in Germany, to find in a short period very qualified artists who are living in this region. Mm-hmm. But I am more interested, we had really now for this trip to Miraflores, we had the chance to speak together. What do you think, where are the difficulties of this project for you as a class teacher?
Honestly, for me, I have absolutely no problems, because I have this special class, and with the time I'm very flexible. Yes. And also, how I just said, my colleagues absolutely like it. But it happens that they have sometimes always like that when you're a teacher, and you have this time pressure. They have time pressure a little bit, because you know they have from 8 o'clock to 12 o'clock, and today it's every day is something different. We have now all these immigrations, we have German projects, and every day is a special help for some children, handicapped children, and then sometimes maybe that's the only problem sometimes for them, not for me. I stand next to them and say, but they have sometimes a time problem.
Yeah.
But I think you always have time problem, because it's always something we have to do.
Yeah.
In the school morning, it's not often that you have your whole class all together. Every hour, sometimes goes out because he has a special thing to do. Learn German.
I heard from teachers that they see that the motivation in general is much higher than the thought of the children. Is this true from your experience?
Yes, I think so. The children absolutely like it, and they always ask me, the name of the artist is Tina. And they, today Tina comes, right? As yeah. They're like that, you can see it in their eyes, and I think it's also very positive for the group dynamics. And also for my multicultural class, I think it's a very, the art, this project is a very good thing because you can do it without any language things. You do it, and because I've got many children who don't speak German yet, and for example, last week we had Carnival, and the painter made a thing like painting each other's faces. And it was cool to see because there is a Muslim Syrian child who paints the face of a Muslim, and they're so happy and do it and really like it, and it's really cool to see.
And do you have children who don't want to participate?
No.
Yeah, se encuentra hay niños que no quieren participar en la actividad museo y le he dicho que no.
No, in my class, no. I think it's very important that you can. It's also a personal thing between the teacher and the artist.
Es also, también es una cosa personal entre el artista y el tutor.
Between us, it's absolutely a cool relationship, and it's absolutely
okay.
Good. But I think it's important also to evaluate this. The dance teacher, I don't know. Mm-hmm. I heard some different opinions about that, I must honestly say. The one says, yes, it's okay. The other teacher says, for me it's a little bit strange. But I don't know if it's a personal problem, mm-hmm. Maybe because she's got no connection to dance in general, mm-hmm. and to these improvisational things, mm-hmm. or if it's true. I will see when I have dance. Mm-hmm. Always like that when people work together, we are humans, and whether there is this connection or not. And I heard two totally different opinions about it. The one teacher said, oh, it's cool, very nice, and mm-hmm. the other one says, I don't know, it's her. So I don't know.
But therefore, the role of the coordinator, the local coordinator, is very important. The balance between teacher, artist, and child. And if this balance is disturbed, the coordinator must find solutions to speak with the people and so on.
I think it's very important that you directly solve the problems, yeah. If there are personal problems, but yeah. The children feel it. Because the one teacher says to me, oh, my children absolutely like it. The dance thing, and the other one says, oh no, my children, the boy says, no, I don't want to dance. But I think, in my opinion, it's a spiritual thing, because the children feel that the teacher is not convinced. It's always like that. When we have in Germany also a food program, once a week we get some fruits, and when the teacher then says, oh, I don't like, then also the children, and I say, and then all the children eat just for.
It's really a pity that the headmaster of the school could not be here, because the role of the headmaster is also very important. And if he would be here, you could feel how convinced and excited he is that he has in his school now this music project. Yeah, so I think it's time to open the discussion and to have, you have questions maybe.
Yo quería añadir una cosa para los artistas que comentaba ella sobre el profesor, si es que la energía del artista también es muy importante, porque cuando tú llegas a la clase vienes de tus cosas, de tus proyectos, de tu vida, y ellos lo perciben mucho. Y cualquier cosa que tú lleves contigo, ellos les llega. Si yo llego enfadada, pues inmediatamente esa energía la traspaso. Y es interesante.
Que she wants to add to what you were saying, that that sometimes it's the tutor that gives there's no connection to the tutor and the artist, but she says that sometimes the artist itself it's not in a good mood, maybe, or what brings the way he comes into the class.
Yes.
This is really important. The children feel that.
Mm-hmm.
She said maybe you come, you're a bit upset or hungry for something else, and the children feel it.
You are a class teacher.
No.
You are a teacher
it's
or an artist?
Yes.
What kind of art?
Theater.
Mm-hmm.
Para mí es interesante hacer un trabajo siempre, antes, aunque sea de un minuto, para respirar y decir, vale, voy a trabajar con ellos. Voy entera, no puedo decir, tengo que estar en el presente, no puedo decir, vale, voy a trasladar todo lo que yo cargo conmigo, mi energía, no.
And what she does before is a personal work. It could even take a minute, but it's just to tell herself, okay, now I'm gonna go in and I'm gonna be 100% with them. Carry the all of me, carry them, not to leave out, and not to leave out anything.
I think as a class teacher, it's also important that you help the artist a little bit, because he doesn't know the class at first, and you have all your pedagogical things, and they give you a reaction as a class teacher, and so you can make silence, for example, and then the artist can start.
I think the ideal form is if it comes to a sort of team teaching situation. The artist comes with his art, and the teacher comes with his pedagogical competence.
Es que piensa que es importante encontrar un espíritu de grupo donde el tutor que lleve un poco de su experiencia pedagógica y el artista también un poco de su experiencia artística y se encuentren los dos.
I remember a visit in Zurich, a class, a Muse class, and it was a production, a theater production, and the children have created this content of the piece by themselves.
Esta se acuerda de una experiencia que tuvo en Zurigo, en una producción de teatro teatral de los niños, donde el contenido del texto teatral estaba escrito, realizado por ellos mismos.
Yes, and the artist, the actor, he was the regisseur.
Yes.
And the teacher was the regie assistant.
Donde,
so it was perfect.
Perfect. Donde, en este.
In that sense, we as the teacher team or the team that works in schools, we have an enormous responsibility, because we also are able to use the experience, the music experience, in a transversal way. And maybe to use it also in other subjects, as mathematics or language or. And I'm talking about this responsibility we have. It's a sharing responsibility.
I absolutely agree with you. And it was also coming back to Yehudi Menuhin, one of the basic ideas, that the experience doesn't come from reading a book. The experience comes is true life, and that learns us the most.
There are centers in Spain with such a problematic situation that the artists have the enormous responsibility to take the all the weight of the program. Let's say that. And what I wonder is that if maybe we can give these children
this opportunity to have this like, kind of testing experience of art, this is an enormous thing we can do already.
And that gives the children the one moment of light, of joy, and that maybe that's the only moment of joy and light that they have, because usually they don't. And we're talking not about only in the school, but in the family in general.
I remember 2 years ago, I was with a German radio journalist in Kosovo.
Hace 2 años estaba con un jornalista de radio en Kosovo.
And you all know the name from the news, Mitrovica. You know this.
Todos conocéis el nombre para las noticias, ¿no? Mitrovica.
It's a divided city, and one day, shortly before we came, the Serbian community closed the bridge with a huge earth and stones and so on. Nobody could anymore cross the bridge. And then a mother said, and in the Mitrovica school we could observe a class with folk dance, with Albanian folk dance. It was absolutely touching, I must say. And after that, the journalist interviewed a mother and asked, "What do you think about Muse?" And this mother said, "The two lessons per week with the artist are the only time in the week where our children forget the drama of the everyday." Mm-hmm. Yeah. That was one of my deepest impressions in the whole museum. Yeah, other remarks or questions? It's a very interesting discussion.
I wanted to go back to the my colleague was talking about before, that memories that the children have after the Muse experience. And I think it's kind of a seed we put to let it grow, and this is very important. Do you remember, Annabelle, this project we did about seeds? I remember also in Canary Islands, these children that I was working for, that after a few years, I was asking them if they were remembering the program, and they said that they were very proud of it. And this is something that we have to keep as artists. And also I want to emphasize in the idea of the artists, like how responsible we are for these children as artists. Also, this other colleague was talking about the experience in this theater in Mérida, where the children will remember that experience in the future.
The Roman theater. Yeah, yeah.
That they would remember that in the future for sure.
I'd like to go back to what he was saying about the place that, like you said, in Kosovo there was the situation that really is struggling. My father used to tell me story about the war and how my grandfather, sorry, and how war brings out the human aspect and the friendship and unity. You forget a lot of things, and you. Friendship is much stronger, and I would like you to ask, what do you think in a place like Spain, for example, in Barcelona, there are families where they're struggling but they're not in a situation of war. Their context is so they're struggling in their family, maybe they're struggling in their life, they're struggling in the class, but all that's around them, it's happy and fun, and it, I found it, it's, I don't know, it's easier. Music, it, in a way, it's easier in Kosovo where there's war, because it's easier to get into the heart of people in that sense, and it's much more difficult to get in the heart of the students in a context where
maybe you translate it to the, your friends. I can give you a very clear answer. I'm born in Germany, like I told you. I'm living 40 years in Bern. Switzerland is a country, objective, there are no problems. There is no war, there is no very small criminality, and so on. But the people, and the people earn a lot of money, but they are always quarreling. But I think the children need the same, because they are, from their soul, they are poor, because these parents who are poor. And as a director of the conservatory, I can say it was sometimes so difficult. They had to go to tennis, to ballet, to the instrument, and so on and so on. So they didn't find time to come to themselves. Maybe you translate. And I can say I heard, after the Second World War, when Germany was destroyed as a country, never so many people visited concerts than at that time when all was destroyed. That is a proof that the arts are very important for our life. And that is the key why we started music, to close the circle.
Están organizando un concierto en el campo de concentración de Bergen-Belsen. El 28 de agosto. El 28
de agosto próximo.
Es el campo de concentración en donde Yehudi Berujin fue, cuando se liberó Alemania, esto, con Benjamin Britten, que era un amigo suyo, que era compositor, y estuvo una semana en el campo y tocó ante, bueno, los que estaban con el pijama rayas, como habéis visto. Y les dijo una cosa, les dijo, y él era judío, les dijo, hay que condenar el nazismo, pero no hay que condenar al pueblo alemán. Y esto lo va a celebrar Werner y vamos a echar una mano.
Hay ambas dos.
¿Dónde podemos comprar entradas?
I was there to be
he wants to buy tickets.
Yeah, you can.
Okay.
I was 2 weeks ago there for my first time in my life in this it's now the camp is destroyed. There's a military camp still existing, and in this military camp happened the concert. And so this is still existing. And it was for me naturally very touching, you can imagine. Yeah, so the reason is that Yehudi Menuhin would be 100 years old this year, not 70 like me. and because of this symbolic anniversary, we do this concert. So I thank you very much for this very interesting workshop, and you have so much experience. I feel it, what your potential is here, and continue, and let's follow this mission of Yehudi for a better world finally.